Yours truly.
This here's a picture of me whenever I was younger.
All right, guys, Dane here in the Man Cave, Code 4.
Look what was waiting for Obi-Wan when I got back from visiting my dad. I'll be showing you these in a wee bit on the DR. Come on. Front tire, Mitas C07s. So that's the front before. Here's the rear, the Mitas C07s. My broken chevron tread pattern is all but gone. After. These are not directional. Shinko 244s. That's what I went with. There's the back. That's the 5.1 wide. I went with the wider one. And it fits fine. There's plenty of clearance. Yeah, see? It fit on there fine, no problem. The 5.1. They say it's a little heavier, but what, a pound? And I just packed all the wheel bearings. Found a good video on it. I'll post a link in the description below from a guy I follow called, his handle is Verbal Widget. He's got a lot of really good stuff. I'll tell you, I've said it before, I'll say it again. Breaking the bead on the rear tire on the DR is incredibly difficult, which means I don't have the right tools or know-how or whatever, but I got it. But if you're out in the middle of nowhere, unless you're towing your shed behind you, that tire ain't coming off.
One thing I think is important to know, I'm standing in the exhaust, the front is rated at 75 miles an hour. The rear is rated at 93 miles an hour. So if you're the Verbal Widget, let's just say, and you're gonna get out on the highway, spin up to Jerome, and you may be on the freeway going, let's just say 80 miles an hour or whatever. I don't want to mislead you, probably be all right. But I want you to know what the tires say. Because of the speed limitations, these may not be the tires for you. My style of riding, these are going to be fine. I found a review on these. New skins. All the wheel bearings have been packed. Really good video on that by the Verbal Widget. Link will be in the description below. Oil change, pack the wheel bearings, new skins, and clean and lube the chain. Okay, legal bullshit. I bought this with my own money. Nobody's paying me nothing. I'm not advertising or nothing like this. Okay, this shit here, I hope it works. I may have to use my other camera. Maxima chain wax. It's a paraffin base, good for on-road and off-road use, O-rings safe, and fling resistant. Okay, that is no shit. You can put this on, and as long as you wait, they say 15 minutes. I do mine in the evening, so it sits overnight, and it sticks to the chain with this wax paraffin coating shit, and I have to tell you that I also like the way that it looks, only in that it kind of gives it a gold hue or tinge to it, so to speak. But I lubed the shit out of this the other day. I didn't get to go riding yesterday. I'm gonna take a spin around the block and make sure the police station isn't on fucking fire, and when I get back I'll show you. But compared to your regular lube, this stuff stays on the chain. It doesn't go flinging all over everything. That's good shit. I really like it. I highly recommend it, actually. I use a grunge brush like that to clean my chain. I ran out of kerosene. I like to use kerosene. It's really good for cleaning the chain, and it's safe for the O-rings. All right, let's roll. Oh yeah, she's sitting higher. Fucking A. One thing I was gonna say is there's a real good review. I'll post the link in the description if I haven't already said so. from the Aussies on these tires. And I guess when you get up to, I don't know what the speed is, but a higher speed, they will, I heard that the rear will make a humming noise, but if you air the tires up to 28 pounds, or my bad, the rear tire up to 28 pounds, that humming noise does indeed go away. Stock pressures on the DR are 22 in the front and 25 in the rear, unless you're riding with two people. They also say that airing these down to, you know, 10, 11 pounds is no problem when you get off-road, which is a good idea to do. Unless you want to feel every rock and pebble. But yeah, these feel good, you know, no problem. Apparently they just got a call. Be a good license plate for my mom, Grammy. You can feel those lugs on the corner, I can tell you that. They're not humming at 50, no road noise or anything. Best bike I've ever owned, bar none. 1979 Husqvarna 390 OR, that takes second place. When I used to desert race back in the 70s, late 70s. Yeah, these definitely aren't as cushy as the Mitas EO7s on the road, I can tell you that right now. Well, the police station is not burning, that's good, assholes, these Antifa fucks. If you hate the country so much, get out. Leave. Yeah, I'd say these are more off-road just in this little initial test. Dude, get off my ass. Because this road's a little rough, not too smooth. Unfucking believable. I'm feeling every uneven deal. My intent was a more aggressive tread pattern for the desert. And you're gonna sacrifice one for the other, right? Too many cops around my neighborhood because I live really close to a police station. You ever notice how much happier your bike is when you put fresh oil in it? It just seems like it's happier. Yeah, we'll get it home and put it back up on the rack and look at everything real good. And I've got a major mess to clean up. All clear. Tighten my chain too, so I'm fucking with it a little bit. See? I'm doomed. I want to make sure that that chain isn't too tight. I'm like right on the edge of the 1.2. Let's see how much shit I slung all over the place. You see that? nothing on the wheel, nothing on the sprocket, nothing on the tire. The shit just stays put. That's good stuff.